The Broward Sheriff's Office on Monday released recordings of the 911 calls reporting the fatal Thanksgiving Day excursion that ended with a catamaran capsizing off Pompano Beach. One caller told the operator she could see the vessel bobbing upside down and people in the water. A tourist boat with a lot of people, it flipped over just outside of Hillsborough Inlet, she said from her vantage point at her home. The operator asked how many people were on board and whether they were within reach of the shore. At least 20, she said. They're less than a quarter mile out. At the first buoy, they're easy to see. The caller grabbed some binoculars to get a better view and identified the catamaran as the Coral Princess. A large wave hit the 45-foot vessel and threw 21 passengers and two crew members into the choppy water around 1 p.m. Thursday. A New Mexico woman drowned and three others were hospitalized, investigators said. The witness told the 911 operator she could see a yellow sea tow boat approaching the flailing passengers. The 911 operator called the Coast Guard and learned help was on the way. The caller said people were still in the water. Six people in the water and there's two guys standing on top of the capsized boat, she said. There was no sign of distress, she said. Everybody seems like they are okay because they can probably all swim, she said. I don't see anybody left behind. The Coast Guard operator explained the group had been on a commercial vessel. They're a diving vessel and everybody in the water was diving, he said. The Coast Guard is investigating the capsizing while the Broward Sheriff's Office probes the drowning death of Nina Popplesdorf, 54, of Sandia, NM. Captain Dennis Winchester, 53, was at the helm of the catamaran owned by South Florida Diving Headquarters in Pompano Beach. Jeff Durrell owns the diving operation. Popplesdorf was on vacation with her nephew, Mark Domer Smith, 23, of Pittsburgh. She taught a basic open water diving course at New Mexico Scuba Center and worked at Sandia National Laboratories. Her funeral will be Saturday in Edgewood, NM, Domer Smith said. A second service will be December 9th in Popplesdorf's hometown of Charleston, WVA. Domer Smith said.